Alright, and welcome today. So, we are going to show you how to set up a Hikvision IP video intercom kit in under 5 minutes. Well, hopefully we are, anyway. So, what have we got? Okay, then. So as you see, it comes as a complete kit in a box. You can have this wired or wirelessly set up. We are setting up wire today, so you will need an additional PoE switch, which is sold separately, and a couple of cables, that's all you need. So let me show you what we got. So the model number is the DS-KIS603-P, and there's a B in brackets as well. So what do you get in this kit? So let me show you. All right, here's one I opened earlier, and we have our doorbell or door station for outdoor, simple buzzer there, and we have our indoor screen monitor. Okay. So, nice little lightweight flat screen there. Alright then, and I'll show you how to set this up. So, this is fresh out the box. We bought a Hikvision PoE switch separately. It's a little 4-port switch. And all we've done is connect that to the internet. And we've got a couple of short cables here just to show you how to set it up. Alright then, so first things first, we'll plug in our units. Okay, might need a screwdriver for the lid. Unscrewed it earlier. Okay, that's in. The lights come on now. Means it's powering up. Okay. Okay, there we go. All right, so this is so easy to configure and set up. I'll show you. Right, okay, so no additional software PCs needed. We could do it straight from the software on the monitor. And that beeping was just the doorbell powering up. Alright then, so we need a password. So create a password. SSR CCTV 1, 2, 3. Okay. SSR CCTV 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we just make a quick password. Okay, select our language. Okay, so now we have to enable the DHCP. Okay, this is an important stage. As you see, our local IP is set at 192.0.0.64. Okay, this is not going to work. What we need to do is enable the DHCP, and you'll see it changes the IP address to something more local. And so we click on this little button up here, slide it across, or click on it. There we go. It's turned green. Okay, now you see it went green, and then it went back. That's what's supposed to happen. But you see the local IP has now changed. It's changed to 10.4.4.82. That's what we want. Okay, so that means the IP is now changed and we can go to the next stage. Next. Okay, so on this next one, all we have to do is the SIP password. So we click on here, not configured. Okay, on the little triangle. And we put in the same part, we could put the same password as before. So SSR CCTV 1, 2, 3. Okay. There we go. Okay. Okay, we go next. Okay, as we see now, this is our doorbell door station for outdoor. As you can see, it's inactivated. We just need to quickly activate it. Active. Yes, please. Active. Successful. Okay, now it's another important stage. We need to enable the DHCP again, but now on the door station. So we click on this cog, and we have the same thing as before. So we've got current IP is 192.0.0.65. We need to change that. So we click on DHCP here. There we go. It's gone green. Okay, it hasn't changed the IP yet. Let's wait. Okay, so it's try it, click it off and on again. All right, we'll come back to this and to double check it in a minute. Okay. So, okay. All right, and that's it. We finished this. Okay, that's the wizard run through. We're just going to quickly check the configuration. So we go configuration, we put in our password. Okay, now we go to our indoor station, main door station here. Okay, and we check the DHCP again. Okay, as you see now, it has changed. 10.4.4.8.3. Let's double do it just to make sure. I'll do it again. Click on OK. Okay, and now, you see here 10.4.4.8.3. That should be enabled now. So go back to our main screen. Okay, and now that's it. It should be set up. Just about 5 minutes. So let's test it out. Let's ring the bell. See what happens. There we go. Ringing first time. So, simple as that. Hope you guys enjoyed that and liked it and learned something today. And hopefully, if you're interested in one, come check us out. Thank you. Cheers. Bye.